We've spent the past 2 years doing everything possible to dodge COVID, but
Omicron is a gear change.
Now we're being told to
be prepared.
Have some paracetamol or some ibuprofen in your cupboard.
People who have COVID should contact their GP.
I've never seen so many sick people not knowing whether or not they need to go to hospital.
I'm so damn confused.
If you've just been diagnosed with COVID, the first thing I would say is take a deep breath. It sucks.
That's Dr. Mariam Chalan. She's a GP and she knows what it's like to test positive.
I'm currently day 7 after testing positive for COVID. My twin 18-month-old boys are also on day 7. Yeah, it was a bit of a rollercoaster ride.
Like Dr. Mariam, 80% of people who do catch the virus are likely to have mild symptoms that can be managed at home. So if you receive this message or get the dreaded double-line RAT result...
No! God, please, no! No!
Here's what to expect.
Fever, fatigue, runny nose, sore throat, headaches, muscle pain. Some have some nausea, vomiting, diarrhea or some abdominal pain.
And there are some simple supplies you can keep in your cupboard to prepare.
A thermometer, paracetamol, ibuprofen, some throat lozenges, some Hydralyte, and a Netflix subscription.
Just a basic, proper disinfectant. Not the one just for bacteria, but the ones for viruses.
But remember, just chill on the number of boxes you buy.
Stop it.
If you're not living alone, there are ways to protect the rest of your household.
Make sure that you've got masks. Ventilation is really important with COVID, so open the windows. Make sure that you're wiping down the surfaces and you're avoiding any contact with any other members of the household.
And while it's important not to jump the gun,
for the healthy people that generally have mild symptoms, there's really no need to contact your GP.
There are some red flags to be aware of.
Chest pain. Severe breathlessness, if you're coughing up blood, if you're feeling confused or drowsy, if you're unable to pass water, feel cool or clammy, they're definitely reasons that you should call the ambulance.
But don't forget,
for the vast majority of us, we will have a mild course of illness and make a full recovery.
Some pretty good tips there, but as the new COVID correspondent, I have a few other ones to share. So I had a pretty, I think it was pretty bad in that I was sick for 2 weeks, like really sick. It wasn't a mild sniffle. I couldn't get in touch with my doctor, so I actually befriended a doctor on Twitter and he gave me some advice.
A real doctor?
Oh, I hope so, because I was whinging about how I was feeling and he would, you know, give me some pointers, I guess, so that's my tip. Another thing would be adopt a large ethnic family that can drop off meals, because I had so much food. So
how would I get one of those?
I don't know.
But
on Twitter. Yeah, turn on Twitter. Ask the doctor.
Media.
Dr. Tom, thank you. And pets, that was something I hadn't thought about, like what to do with my puppy, a really energetic puppy who needed to be walked. So I don't know, maybe have...
You all had it in the house.
We all had it. We were all so sick for 2 weeks. Couldn't leave the house. One time I tried to... I got to the, you know, the letterbox to try and walk the pup, and I had to turn around and lay down. And so I guess that's something you don't really think about, what to do with your puppy.
Have you eaten all the food yet?
No, they're still... I mean, I have two freezers, because any self-respecting ethnic has to have two fridges and two freezers. And I've frozen some of it. Oh, and the other thing, an oxymeter. Have you heard of that?
No, what is it? It
measures your oxygen. So I guess the only time you really need to, you know, call an ambulance, I mean, this is my medical advice, take it loosely,
from Twitter,
from Dr. Tom, is to see how your lungs are operating. And you put it on your finger and it tells you, you know, where your rate should be between 93 and 100. If you're under that, you should probably call 000.
So this is COVID that you were diagnosed with at Christmas time and you've had for 2 weeks, so you're only just out of it. How are you feeling right now?
I still feel tired. I still have headaches. I don't have my usual energy levels. I still have my taste, thankfully. But no, I'm not myself.
And you were saying before that you're still contagious too, right?
No, not that part, thankfully.
This from the guy that calls himself Dr. Tom on Twitter.
I was chatting to you a few weeks ago.
Sorry, Lisa.
Just, you know, I've got a lot of food I can drop off. Thank you.